In this video, I will show how I make a pattern welded scimitar sword. I start with stacking two types of tool steel. I stack until I have 16 layers. I use 02 steel and 12767 steel. 12767 steel has 4% nickel in it. I weld the billet together using MIG welding. I did all kinds of welding in the past, including construction for buildings, but also TIG welding for robotics and design articles. Borax is used to protect the steel and help the fire welding process. Borax shields the steel from oxygen, preventing scaling. Scale inclusion is disastrous for fire welds. The steel has to be clean and close to melting temperature for the fire welds to stick. After cooling down, the steel gets grinded clean. The steel gets chopped in 3 equal pieces. I use a surface grinder to get a very even surface. This helps a lot with clean fire welding. I repeat this process until I have a billet of 432 layers. billet goes into the vermiculite. This is a heat-resistant isolation powder. It makes the steel cool down very slow, pacifying the steel structure. This helps in the further forging process. The nickel steel is air hardening, making it very hard to drill even when cooled down slow. I drill in the steel. This process perforates the upper layers, making the Damascus structure more intense. You can already see the layers. The steel gets flattened. This, combined with the drilling, creates a teardrop Damascus pattern. The steel is now 70 cm by 5 cm by 8 mm. I start with the tip. The sword I forge is complex to make. There are multiple forging phases. A press mold is used to press in the profile. This technique is old. Some people say it was already used with water wheel driven forges in the Renaissance, maybe even earlier. Another press mold is used to forge in the fuller. Wood is used to correct the curvature of the blade. The wood does not damage the edge. The fullers get cleaned out in freehand. This is a tricky process. A quick etch is done to see how the pattern came out. The pattern looks great. It has to have an oiling water look. The scimitar I forged is a brutal blade. It's around 90 centimeters long. The blade gets a fire-resistant coating. This coating protects the steel from oxygen. Oxygen creates scale. This reaction can cause carbon migration, making the surface of the steel less hard. This coating prevents this. The sword is annealed. The blade has to cool down slowly. I use the planks for this. They keep the blade from warping, but also create a carbon-rich isolating environment. The annealing process eases out remaining stress in the steel structure. An even crystal structure makes for a more impact-resistant blade. The blade is quenched in a medium speed oil. The blade is subtracted at boiling point and placed in the planks. This is a hardening method that already generates a first temper. At 300 degrees Celsius, it stops the cooldown and eases the cooldown out after that. This method generates a very tough blade. Fire temper is done. This temper is differential, heating the core more than the edge, creating a very flexible core and a harder edge. The blade is etched. For etching, I use a mixture of 50% ferric chloride and 50% white vinegar. After the etching, I pacify the acid and clean the blade with water. After hardening, the pattern comes out much stronger. I am very happy with the result. The steel is flawless in my opinion. The positioning of the blade fitting is marked with center marks. I use a punch blank I made before to press in the fitting hole. The center marks make positioning the punch blank much easier. The first press does not have to be deep. The first one determines the positioning. The final punch through is done on the anvil. The guard is hot fitted. This method creates a tighter fit. Before I use grinding belts, I always remove scale. The scale is very hard and wears down the belts quickly. It's going to be a wing style guard. I made etching stencils to etch in the feather pattern. I use a gun blue solution to darken the guard. The handle is made out of sheet metal. The handle shape is a phoenix. It has to be shaped in a traditional style. I use sheet metal to make it lighter. It will become a ceremonial sword, but it still must be functional. This handle takes me back to the days I made steel sculptures. I graduated as a sculptor 20 years ago. As an artist, I used all kinds of materials, like concrete, stone and wood, but steel was my favorite material to work with. I use sand as a filler. This will prevent the tube collapsing when bending it. Thank you. A bolt is used, as I did not find the right size steel bar. I use brass in contrast with the black steel. It's a very unique piece. I use recycled wood for my scabbards, mostly pine. Rings are made for the scabbard. I looked for rings to buy, but cannot find the right size. I use electric etching for engravings. It's a very controllable technique and also very safe. I use a simple mixture of salt and water. The current I use is around 5 volts. The distinctive handle is based on the Lebanese legend of the phoenix, a myth that can be traced back to the Phoenician times. The phoenix, a firebird from paradise, lives 500 years, filling the air with its heavenly voice before perishing in fire. It then rises from the ashes to live another 500 years.